Hey guys, it is Max here, aka Shockwave. So a lot of YouTubers seem to think, especially starting YouTubers, that it is very complicated to design a good thumbnail for their videos. And that is a waste because it is actually not really that complicated. And thumbnails are a very important part of your channel, of your overall design and look of your channels and videos. So I'm just gonna go ahead and show you how to design good thumbnails right in Microsoft PowerPoint. So if you have a Windows PC, PowerPoint should already be on your computer. If not, just download or buy it. If you have a Mac, I think you can kind of do the same in Keynote, or just in PowerPoint for Mac. As you can see here on the left, I have quite a few thumbnails. I tend to save them if I want to use the design in the future. For this video though, we're gonna only look at this thumbnail. This is one I made for a review of a pair of headphones, and we're gonna break every element of it down, and I'm gonna show you how I made it and how you can do the same. So first of all, this thumbnail is very clearly divided into three big elements. So of course the layout and design of the thumbnail kind of depends on the video you are making. You can see that in the thumbnails I make, they are all very different from each other. So as you can see, there are three big things. The first is the image of the product itself, just a clear image so that the people can see what it looks like. The second is a promotional image, so that's kind of as a background of the thumbnail, or as a image of the product itself at the same time. And here you can see the text box. It says what the video is about, what the video is and what it's about. So it's a review about this headphone. So first of all, let's look at the text box. You can see the text is very big, and that is very important because the thumbnails are very small. So your text must be very big in order for your people to be able to actually read the thumbnail with ease. You also gonna make sure you use a clear font. So here I use DIN Pro Bold. That's actually a pretty good font. I use the same in this thumbnail. You also gonna make sure you have a high contrast. So if I, for example, make the text this color of red, you don't see it at all, especially on YouTube. So here I have the text in size 80. The subtext is in size 55, so it doesn't have to be that size. Just find out what works best for your video. How I made this this text box is very easy. Just go to insert, shapes, rectangles. Just do the normal rectangle right on the left. Right on the left. Great. Alright, here we have rectangle. This is the standard design of that. We just go to format shape. In this case, we're giving it a solid fill. I used this dark red color and I made it quite a bit transparent. You want to remove the line, or you can do a white line or a black line, whatever you want, what looks best on your video. And then you just enter the text you want. The text is also by default in Calibri, so we can make it DIN Pro. Which one black? It was light. There we go. I think. No, this. It's DIN Pro Bold. Sorry. DIN Pro Bold. There we go. And there you have it. This is basically how I designed this text box. You can also see this has a shadow. If you want a shadow, you just go to, you select your thing, and then you go to format, shape, effects. You can all do all types of effects. Here I'm just gonna do a shadow, which is at the top of the text box, and there you go. That's how I basically made this text box. Here we have the second major part of this thumbnail, which is an image of the product itself. I just got this image from Google. I always make sure to have an image without the white background. How I do that is just I type in Google Images the name of the product and then PNG, because PNG images most of the time don't have white background, so they have a transparent background. Just make sure that is in the same position as was before. You can also do an image with a white background and then do remove background, which should remove the background, isn't perfect, and I didn't want to do that. But yeah, it's always best to have an image without a background, so you can select the background itself, yourself. I also did do a white background behind this image, because without it, it is not really that clearly visible. I just wanted to go for the best possible visibility of this image right here, so I made this little white thingy behind it, and I actually made that in the exact same way as I made the text box. It's just a shape, but in this case it is a gradient, so on the right it is more transparent and then it becomes more filled towards the left, so you have that effect right here, so the image of the headphone is more clearly visible while at the same time blending in with the other image, which is the third major part of this thumbnail, which is just a promotional image on the Sony website, and it figures as a background for the thumbnail and an image of the headphone itself at the same time. You can see that's actually all this thumbnail is made of, so it isn't that complicated at all. As you can see, I think nearly everyone is capable of doing this. You just gotta have a little bit of design skills to be able to make it like that. It just requires a little bit of practicing, but I think everyone should be able to get used to this and make this these kind of thumbnails right in Microsoft PowerPoint. So I hope you liked this video. I hope you can use it in your own videos on YouTube or whatever website you want to use, you publish your videos on. If you like this video, you can subscribe for more stuff. Click the like button if you liked it, share it with your YouTube friends, designer friends, whatever, and then I will see you in the next one.